So how we can differentiate between the linear regression from the logistic regression? So let us consider how can we differentiate. So in a linear regression, you can see that it is used to solve the regression problem. The response variable are continuous in the nature. Okay, so the response variable are continuous in the variable means nature means you can increase the salary of employee by the 5,000, 10,000, 15,000, 12,000, 18,000. So there is a continuous increment. So that is called the continuous in nature. So linear regression is always in a continuous in the nature, and it helps estimate the dependent variable when there is a chance in the independent variable. And it is used the straight line to represent the linear regression. While on the other hand, the logistic regression used to solve the classification problem. Okay. So the linear regression is used to solve the regression problem, while the logistic regression is used to solve the classification problem. The response variable is categorical in a nature. It is not a continuous in nature. It is a categorical. Okay, categorical means it may be a yes, it may be a no. Okay, it may be a tall, it may be a short, it may be a day, it may be a night. Okay, so it is a categorical. So you can make the category of boy, girl. So if you want to such kind of category, so in this condition you have to use the logistic regression. It helps calculate the possibility of particular event taking place. Okay, so and the formula to find out the logistic regression is called the sigmoid function, or also called as a S curve, while the linear regression is the straight line. Now the logistic regression, what are the application or what are the example of logistic regression? So the logistic regression applications are weather prediction. So let us consider you want to give the prediction of weather. So help determine the kind of weather that can be expected. So it can be used to image categorization. For image categorization, it is also useful to categorize the animal. Let us consider on the upper side, there is a mix of images. So it has the animal, it has a human, it has a vehicle, all are mixed together. But when you apply the logistic regression, so this logistic regression is classify these images into the three class. Let us consider the human, let us consider the animal and the vehicle. So it makes a image classification properly. So logistic regression is also useful for the image classification. And logistic regression is also useful for the healthcare. Okay, in the healthcare sector, the logistic regression application is used. It determines the possibility of patient survival. If you want to find out if the patient is survive or not, so you have to take his age, then ISS value, then RTS value. Okay, so using this RTS means receive TAMUA score, then the injuries severity score, so and his age. So based on that, we have used the percentage of survival. So how, what are the percentage of patient is survive? Okay, so using the logistic regression, you can give the such a type of result. So these are the examples of